there are 500 plus universities in India. Government says 25 universities are actually protesting. Protesters say around 40 universities are protesting. Even that 40 is also not even 10% of the universities we have. But yeah, we are not considering about the protest or whatever it is. But we are more concerned about what is there in the act. Because as a civil aspirant or, you know, as a, what you call, as a citizen, as a person who is going to give an exam in the month of May, we are concerned about what is in the act. So what is in the act? What is in the act of CAA? Because NPR or NCR, it's not been approved. Not it been approved, so something which is been approved only we have to talk about. Right? So, yeah, go on. NPR, no? Not NCR. NPR, NPR cabinet approved. We are waiting for, the census 2021. Yes, what is there in CAA? Constitutional Amendment Act. No, it's not Constitutional Amendment Act. Citizenship Amendment Act. Yeah, what's there in that? I was thinking about starting my lecture about that only, with discussing CAA only, because you will definitely get a question in prelims or mains on Article 11. Article 11 is important for the exam, prelims or mains, whatever it is. So, and also the 5 ways of acquiring citizenship we discussed last time. And what are the ways where you can, your citizenship can be removed, right? Termination, you have renunciation, right? Even that also. So, question will never be asked, right? Even in IPC or CRPC, some important sections will be there. Like if something is discussed in Supreme Court, those sections will be asked, right? But articles in Constitution, yes, definitely they will ask. Like we have seen 142 article last time. Yes. Why 31st December 2014? Because BJP formed. That's it. There is no rationale. There is no rationale. There is no reason why they have chosen that particular date. What they believe is after they came into power, they believe nothing illegal migrant or something like that actually happened. But it's happening even now. It happens every day between India, Bangladesh. India, Bangladesh, it happens every time. Afghanistan, actually Afghanis come to India, but in less number. They go to other countries. They are migrants in other countries. Syria. Nepal is borderless, na? So we are only allowing Nepalis to come to do business and go back. Nepal and Bhutan. Last year what happened, Nepal government, they banned, they put a ban on Indian 100 rupees. Why? Because a lot of business happening with Indian rupee and Nepali rupee is not emerging. It is not growing. So they want to protect their rupee. So that's why they has put a ban. But even now, many Nepalis come to UP, Bihar, they work, they go to their home at the end of the day. So that is what they do. Yes, as you rightly mentioned, after 2007, Chinese intervention we have seen in Nepal, because we have a friendship treaty signed between India and Nepal. According to the friendship treaty, India will guard the borders of Nepal. India will guard the borders of Nepal. In return, Nepal will not have embassies of five countries. Nepal will not have embassies of five countries. What are these five countries? P5 countries. You know P5 countries? United Nations P5 countries. What are they? US, China, UK, France, and Russia. So, in return, Nepal will not have embassies of these five countries. And we are going to guard their border. Now, if any Nepali want to visit these five, any of these five countries, they have to come to Delhi and they have to apply. So, that was the exchange. But now in future, I don't think so this will happen. Chinese intervention we are seeing. A lot of Chinese investment. The problem with Chinese investment is, if China is investing anything in any country, it is very difficult for that country to repay back. So China invests so much that the country cannot repay back. Sri Lanka we have seen, Nepal we are seeing, African countries. If you look at Colombo, every street, every lane, it's China only. They have built the infrastructure. Colombo is another world in Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka is different and Colombo is different. Everything is China only there. So they can't repay the money. They are not in a position to.
They actually do a very much business and attack the big market.
Yes, trap. Yeah. It's kind of a money trap, investment trap. Chinese, no? So, and we don't fall in the trap. That's why there is always an enmity between India and China. Because we have these Chinese goods, right? But there is a dumping duty on that.
Yes.
And second thing, in India, there is a notion that all Chinese products, irrespective of their standard, are considered cheap. Right? You know what? Everything we consider, it is so cheap. Right? For example, even you see MI phones, anything. So, if Chinese product, kya karita hai bolte? Like it is like that. Even though they are standard, we consider them as cheap. That's all. So, we have some other vision over Chinese products. Secondly, what will happen in the future is the trade war between China and India. China is not allowing some sectors to be imported from India, like textile and pharma. Chinese is stopping our textile industry and pharma to enter into China. So that is one thing India will complain now in WTO. When India complains in WTO, now China will allow some sectors which they have blocked before. Now when they allow, the total trade between China and India is $60 billion. In 2017 it was $60 billion, and you know, out of 60 billion, 40 billion is imported to India and 20 billion is exported to China. So we are in deficit now. So we are in deficit of around $20 billion again. So when they allow the market, when they allow India's textile market, now this 20 billion deficit will be, I getting my point, right? Nowadays there is lots happening on, what is that? Onion. Huh? So India is on onion economy. Nowadays, 3 months back, Sheikh Hasina, madam, you all know. Who is she? Muzaffar Rahman's daughter, huh? Okay, so she's a daughter of Muzaffar Rahman and the Prime Minister of Bangladesh. And India stopped the export of onions to Bangladesh. Now when she was there in India, the stoppage of the onions export to Bangladesh have created a shake in Bangladesh economy. That's what she mentioned. Aapka onion humko, you know, bahut takleef diya. So that's what she mentioned. Now, in India only the onions are, making us a lot of trouble. It is more than dollar, right? It is around $2 now. $2.5. 120? 160? I have seen it 200 also. Okay, the highest is 200. The highest is 200. The lowest is 90, I saw. Okay. Taka. Bangladesh Taka, you know. Okay. But onions, the good quality onions, you get it for 150 to 200. So it's almost $2 to $3.
Yes.
So it is more than dollar now, right? And one of the farmer, he's from which state. He stored all the onions he has harvested in his warehouse. Now when suddenly the market has increased, he earned 1 crore rupees by selling, he earned 1 crore with that LLC.
So most of the farmers are rich in India, but somehow in some sectors we are facing deficit of farmers.
Now from exam point of view, what is important from this inference? There is no link between government and farmers. There should be a proper link between government and farmers, wherein the government should ensure there is a balance of cropping. Meaning, the government should tell the farmers that next year we need this much production of the so particular crop. Are you getting my point? Demand and supply forecast. There should be a demand and supply forecast between the government and as well as the farmers. This is missing in India. Because when someone says next year, this year I got so much money from onions, see next year there will be onion surplus. Why? Because of the deficit, everyone will put onions only this time.
Yes.
Next year it will be surplus. Now the kg onion will be 5 rupees. It is like that. So there is no proper chain between the farmers and the government. So this we need to maintain. You have to include this point in your essay or economy. Try to demand and supply linkage or connection between farmers and the government, okay, or primary sector and government.
But what about the other factors?
What is
that?
Correct.
How can you control the other factors?
Warehouse. We need to have a proper warehouse facility. The government of India lacks the warehouse facilities, right? So this is one fact. This is one thing government should concentrate on. Instead of providing the PDS and all, government should mostly concentrate on having warehouses, cold storages, right? You know. We have many of such, and the Indian Meteorological Department can forecast the rainfall, and government should know this information before, or otherwise the Prime Minister of India should say the weather forecast every month in his Mann Ki Baat. So earlier he will talk to people of India, so he should also say this month the weather forecast is right, because even now also farmers listen to radio. So that's the reason I'm saying. Okay, so let's come back to our topic, our favorite topic, our interesting topic. Something is happening in the country. 370 ho gaya, Ayodhya ho gaya. Abhi, what happened now? CAA or CAA. CAB is not different. That is bill, this is act. When a bill is signed by President of India, it becomes act. So CAB was signed by President of India. Now it becomes CAA. Now this is a problem. I have seen many posts, as you rightly mentioned, many people are protesting.
Yes, sir.
I have seen a message. He says, we have no problem with CAB. We have no problem with CAA. We have problem with CAB. What is this? Jamia University? You know which article gives right to all the people to protest peacefully without arms? Article 19, uske baad. Clause B. Article 19, clause 1, sub clause B. It provides the right to all the people of this country to protest, but without arms, meaning peacefully. Now when it is going in a violent manner, to control law and order, what police will do?
Yes,
sir. I hope you are getting my point. What police can do? Police will never touch. Come. Any of the students who are actually doing it in a peaceful manner.
Yes.
But if something is going against, something which is not in peace, then they will arrest. Right. So we have not started. Don't worry. We are just starting the class. So we are just starting CAA. So we are just discussing about that. What is there in this act? That's what I'm telling. I'm gonna say now. We'll have this for 5 to 10 minutes, and we will come back to the topic which we have to continue. Okay? So we'll deal with this first, and we'll see. Now you all are aware of it, right? What is there in CAA? What is there in CAA? Okay. Before talking about what is there in CAA, hello. Hello, what should I call you? So, please prove me that you are a citizen of India.
I will
accept
that.
Okay. The list has not yet come.
He was born here.
Yeah. He has a point. There are two terminologies in the law. Any wrong? Anything? What happened? This, sir? Okay. There are two terminologies in the law. This is called jus in soli, jus in sanguinis. Soli means by birth. Sanguineous means by blood relation. Jus in soli is there in USA, which is sanguineous in India. Now try to understand this. Suppose a person, we have seen Article 5 to 11. I hope you remember this. Now try to understand this. Suppose a person who is born in India after January 26, 1950 is called an Indian, but either of his parents, his father or mother, should also be an Indian. Are you getting my point? Blood relation. Suppose a person can become a citizen by descent, by resident. Any person who is born outside the country to an Indian father or mother is called an Indian. Correct? We saw that? Yes. Meaning, in India, we give priority to blood relations. Wherever you are, you go wherever you are. If you are born to an Indian father or mother, you are eligible to become an Indian citizen. That is called jus in sanguinis. Now coming to USA. In US, if you are born in US, you are a US citizen. Automatically you are a US citizen. I don't care about your father or mother. That's why you see many of these actors, actress, they go to US to take delivery. Are you getting my point? Why? Because by birth, their son or daughter, they are called the US citizens. Are you getting my point? So that is called by birth. That is called jus in soli. These two terms, please try to understand and please note down somewhere. India for us, jus in sanguinis, by blood relation. Soli, by birth. Yep. Where did you listen these two terms? Oh, Ranganath. Okay, he was talking about this. Great. Okay. CAA only. He also discussed about CAA only. Okay, fine. So, all lectures we'll talk about. Everyone is about that only. But we will see in different angle. Okay? So we are not seeing in the general angle. We want to see in a specific angle, because we are dealing with a topic called politics, right? Because this is important for the exam. Mains or prelims, we don't know, right? It will come. Now tell me, in India, as per the Indian Constitution, there are three kinds of people. One is called Indian citizens, two is called aliens, three is called illegal migrants. Illegal migrants. Now, aliens are of two types. One who comes from Mars, one who comes from Moon, no. Okay? Aliens are of two types. Friendly aliens, enemy aliens. These friendly aliens are also called legal migrants. I hope you are getting my point. In India, as per the Indian Constitution, there are three kinds of people. Indians, you know what are the criteria to become an Indian? Article 5 to 11 talks about this. There are five ways to acquire Indian citizenship. What are they? By birth, by descent, go on, by naturalization, by registration, and by incorporation, incorporating a territory. You can become an Indian citizen. Now, I will give good time for you to take down, or I will dictate points, don't worry about this, or I will give the material. Try to understand this. I want you guys to understand first. If you understand, it will be like, you can write your own notes. Okay? It is like that. Now try to understand this. So any way you can become an Indian citizen, happy. So Indian Constitution says there are three kinds of people. Indian citizens, aliens, illegal migrants. Aliens are of two types. Friendly aliens, enemy aliens. Who are these enemy aliens? When India and other countries which indulge in a war, when India has conducted some war with another country, has participated war with another country, then the citizens of that country are called enemy aliens. These two countries are Pakistan and Bangladesh. China is not an enemy aliens because we lost it. So they are bye-bye. Okay? It is like that. Now we lost, huh? So that's right. First of all, if we are like this, they are showing so much of aggression. If you say you are enemy, they will occupy entire Arunachal Pradesh. So why to tell enemy? So that's why we are saying bye-bye. But we are not keeping quiet these days. If you observe last 8 to 10 years Indian foreign policy is so aggressive, right? Indian foreign policy is like tit for tat. They are not keeping quiet. I mean, they are not silent. If you want to throw a stone, I will throw a mountain on you. So like that they are doing. It is like that. So recently we have seen in POK what happened, right? They have attacked the terrorist camps again. When India is talking about CAA, they are doing their own work, right? It is like that. They are slowly occupying, right? 100 kilometers, right? They are slowly occupying. And UK elections were held December 12th. You know what was the agenda? The Labour Party agenda and the Conservative Party agenda, all the MPs who contested for the elections, they demanded Pakistan to give away POK to India. How much we funded? Are you getting my point? So UK elections, we are taking care of UK elections now. US elections as well. Upkeep Trump Sarkar, right? Audi Modi, that one we all know, right? Fine. I think impeachment, House of Representatives pass, Senate, it will never be passed. because they have majority, na? So don't worry. Exactly. Absolute majority is required, and there are 50 people. 100, sorry. There are 100 people, and they have 60. They have 60 supporters. So no, don't worry. He will be there. Trump uncle will be there till he takes the Nobel Peace Prize, huh? Okay. So I don't want to debate all this. I'll call. Let me come back. Okay, I'm coming back. Now, who are these enemy aliens? India will participate in a war. Now, who are these friendly migrants? Friendly migrants are someone who come to India, with a valid visa and passport. Why? What is the purpose they come? Education or business? Education or business? They come to India with a valid documents. These definitions are given in Foreign Act of 1946, Passport Act of 1920. These definitions of illegal migrants, aliens, is given in which act? Foreign Act of 1946 and Passport Act of 1920. If anyone is found illegal migrant, they are punishable under these two acts. They will be in jail under Foreign Act. They are sent to their country under Passport Act. Immigrants, immigration check, they say, na? When you go to airport, immigration, have you heard of this term? Immigration check. Please, we have to go 3 hours before. Right? Why immigration check? They will see all the valid documents. Now they will say if you are a valid person or illegal person. Now if you find you are an illegal person there, they will send back to your country. Or you will be put in jail. Or I said, right, fine or something like that. Now coming back to this again. So you know who is a friendly alien, who has a valid documents. You know who is an enemy alien, who is not an Indian, but where India fought a war with another countries. Those citizens are called enemy aliens. You know what Indian citizens. Now what is this illegal migrants? Coming to this illegal migrants are of two types. They are one. The first type of illegal migrants are after their visa has been completed. Are you getting my point? If the visa is expired, even after their visa is expired, they are still in the country, then they are called an illegal migrants. Are you getting my point? The second one is, right, who migrated from another country illegally, who have crossed the border, correct, Bajrangi Bhaijaan, who have crossed the border without any document, then he is also an illegal migrant. Are you getting my point? No. First one, okay. If they are here and their visa has been done, they want to enjoy the life. They are habituated to this life. So that's why they don't want to go back. So if they are caught under Foreign Act or Passport Act, something will be done. But what about these people? Why these people will come? I explained these people about this last time when I came. Push in, push out theory. You remember? Push in and push out theory. If the state don't want them, if the state, if the country, if the government don't want these people in their country, where they will go? They will illegally go to another countries. For example, I'm talking about the refugees. Are you getting my point? See, even in these kind of migrants, there are two types of people. One is refugees, one is a criminal minded people. They want to conduct some crime, so they want to cross the border and come to India. Like we have seen Taj Mahal attack, who came from Pakistan to India, to Mumbai. Two, they are refugees. The state don't want these people. the government of that country don't want these people. They don't treat these people well. That ill treatment is called persecution. That ill treatment by the government, by the state, is called persecution. Are you getting my point? Because of the persecution, they become an illegal migrants. There are generally three types of persecutions. How many types of persecutions? Three types of persecutions. One, political persecution. Political persecution. Two, religious persecution. And three, ethnic persecution. Ethnic persecution. This is on the grounds of politics. Awala market, any corruption, or because he has sold the secrets of the country to another country, right? If he is a prime minister of some country and he sold the secrets of that country to another country. Musharraf was persecuted politically. Bhutto was persecuted politically. I hope you remember, in Pakistan. What is ethnic persecution? Ethnic persecution is about caste, language, color, region. Very good. We see this ethnic persecution in Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka. Sinhals and Tamils. Ethnicity. Are you getting my point? Now, religious persecution. If a country declares that country as one religious country, and all the other religions are minorities in that country. All the religions are minorities in that country. And though that majority religion treat this minority religion in an ill-treatment manner or persecuted manner, these are called religious persecution. For example, the Buddhist, the Christians, the Hindus, the Sikh, the Jains in Islamic countries. In Islamic countries I'm talking about. Now, when a country is declaring itself as an Islamic country, their religion is Islam. And all the religions there are minorities. All the other religions there are minorities. Are you getting my point? Sir, how you define a minority in that country? We'll get a question mark. Right? How you define a minority in that country? In each country, there is a constitution. And in that constitution, if there is no protection for minorities on the basis of the language or religion, that country declares itself as Islamic state, wherein all the people should follow that culture. Now, coming to India. Sir, in India, the majority population is Hindu. We see 80%, 75 to 80% is Hindu. Then, even here also religious minorities are there, correct? Yes, everyone? I hope you remember Article 29 and 30. What is Article 29 and 30? Leave the secularism part of preamble. India is a secular country. Leave the preamble. In India, we recognize minorities on the basis of language, culture, sect. Are you getting my point? And Article 29 and 30 protects these minorities. It is our duty as per the constitution to protect the minorities. There are six religions which are termed as minorities in India. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is this? Parsi. Six religions which are called minorities in India. I'm sorry, I have to remove this and I have to keep Muslims. Okay. I hope you are getting my point. Now, it is our duty to protect these minorities. Sir, O Indian, ओ इंडियन माइनॉरिटी है, सो कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन उसको प्रोटेक्ट करना है. अच्छा है सर, वाई वी शुड डैम केयर अबाउट अदर माइनॉरिटीज, वाई वी शुड केयर अबाउट अदर कंट्री माइनॉरिटीज. इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज फॉर इंडिया ओनली ना, नॉट फॉर एंटायर वर्ल्ड. देन वॉट इज द रीजन why we want to give protection for other religious minorities in other countries? India doesn't care in general, but India started caring about other country minorities because there is an illegal migration from that country a lot. If there is no illegal migration from these three countries, what are they? Pakistan, Afghanistan, Bangladesh. If there is no illegal migration from these countries, I don't think so India will care about the religious minorities there. Because of the minorities who are migrant, who are migrating from other countries to India, India is caring for these people. Now, India is caring now, not for the future migrants. India is caring who came already to India after 1971 or after independence from Pakistan, Bangladesh or Afghanistan. Are you getting my point? There are a lot of debates. This is against Article 14 of the Constitution. Many people say this is against Article 14 of the Constitution. Those people who say it is against Article 14 should also know Article 29 and 30. If they know Article 29 and 30, they will never say it is against 14. Are you getting my point? In Assam, I mean almost 40% of the Northeast is exempted from this act. 40%, Schedule 6 states and inner line permit. You know what is inner line permit? Inner line permit states are also exempted. Now Manipur is added as a part of inner line permit only for this specific act. Now, why Assam is exempted? Why people don't talk about why Assam, why other Northeast areas are exempted? The Northeast is exempted, keeping in mind the Assad signed in 1985. As per the Assam Accord, because there are many migration, many people who are illegally coming to Assam and other Northeast areas, there was a MOU signed between Government of India and Assam Government. You know what is that? To protect the native people of Assam. To protect the native people of Assam from these migrants, these illegal minorities, Northeast is exempted. To ensure the culture of the Northeast is protected, they can only go travel through inner line permit. They cannot travel anywhere like that. Are you getting my point? People don't talk about this. One of the disadvantageous demerit of this act is the timing of the act. This is not the time. I hope you are getting my point. Right? This is not the time to actually bring this kind of act when India is in serious economic crisis, when India is in serious economic slowdown, stagnation, economic stagnation it is called. Because this will create more problems, this will create confusion. Right? This is not the time. Why not? Tibet, they recognize Tibet as, no, country. They see Tibet as country. China says Tibet is a part of China. Now there is a agreement between China and India saying that India will never speak about Tibet and China will never speak about Arunachal Pradesh. Because of Tibet only, 1962 war happened. We gave Assamil to Dalai Lama. We gave protection to Dalai Lama. As we gave protection only, China attacked India. Are you getting my point? So because of one person and a war took place between India and China. That's fine. That's completely fine. We are not into that. But one more thing which I see a demerit in this act is, this act don't recognize atheist. I mean people who don't believe in God. People who are not part of any religion. So if people are not part of any religion, what about them? Right? These people don't talk about atheist. That is one thing. These people don't talk about Jews. Jews are also there in Northeast. Myanmar region and etc. So this act doesn't talk about Jews, right? Now, okay, you all know what is there in this act. These minorities from Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Pakistan, who migrated to India illegally before 31st December 2014, can now become Indian citizens. After how many years? No. They can become Indian citizens after 14 years. Now, what is this 5 years? Out of this 14, they have to prove that they are in India for 5 years. Are you getting my point? Meaning, they can become citizens only after 14 years. But in these 14 years, they have to prove they are complete in India for how many years? 5 years. Are you getting my point? Before this, suppose if there is a Pakistani Muslim, majority person, if he want to become a citizen, can he become now? Yes, he can become after 14 years. But 11 years he has to stay in India compulsorily. Are you getting my point? For these people, this 11 has decreased to 5. That's it. Nothing else. After 14 years only, they will become Indians. But for these people, they have to prove that they are in India for 5 years. For other citizens, 11 years, they have to stay. Are you getting my point? So there is a lot of, how many pages the act is? I have shared in the group also. 3 pages. Because of this 3-page act, see, what is happening in India? There is a lot of liberal thinking which is dominating, like USA in India also. It is not good for nation building. We are not supporting the government or we are not against the government. We are here to tell the facts. But that is not the way to protest, right? You know, we have to use the constitutional tools to protest. Are you fast on to death, Karo? Why you want to kill someone? You kill yourself, no? Fast on to death. Don't eat anything for 10 days, 15 days. Show protest in that way. Why you want to kill someone? I don't know. Are you getting my point? Okay, leave that. I have a serious problem with this. One of my friend was actually participant in protest. I told, this is just a bill. When that was a bill, I told, let it become act. You tell me what are the points which you didn't like. Discuss with your friends and tell me. I will help you in filing a case. Are you getting my point? So you can file a case. There is a judiciary. Judiciary interprets the constitution. Are you getting my point? And you know, what was the reply I got? What a joke. What is it? They don't know what is this. They just know, yeah, we are going over. Yeah. India is going to divide and rule policy. I don't know. Yes, if there is a serious problem, protest in a peaceful manner. Protest by using constitutional tools. If the police?
Refrain from giving permission.
Okay.
I'm
talking about this. If you want to do protest, right, by using certain things, you need permission. And if you want to protest, and the protesters are more than 100, you need permission. Now, if you are less than 100, and if you want to protest in a non-violent manner, under Article 19(2) or Clause 1, Subclause B, there is no permission required. Are you getting my point? Now, you know Article 22 we saw. What is Article 22? In that, preventive detention is mentioned. If police know that there is an intelligence report that there is going to be some violence in the future, why will they give permission? Are you getting my point? If they know that there is something which is funded by someone who want to create a violence or violence here, then why will police give permission? Police refrain from giving permission if they have this intelligence report. Are you getting my point? I hope you are getting my point. But there is a way. There is always a way to protest.
That is every protest
has a possibility of... No, it will not. Anna Hazare movement. Was it violent? Total India participated. In Pune, 1,000 people came in support of CA. 1,000 people came. There is no violent.
Even in Bombay,
Even in Bombay also, I guess. I think Bombay, Maharashtra is the only state which is supporting CAA in India. What I can see. Huh? And the CAA is also there. Kerala, it wasn't violent? It wasn't violent. Only in Delhi it was violent. In Assam it was more violent. Mangalore also it was violent. You know what? I hope you know Usmani University?
Yes.
In Hyderabad, right? I stay near to Usmania. I was in Usmania. I got a call from my friend. Are you safe? Why are you asking me? And there is a lot of protest happening in Usmania University. People are throwing stones. So people also were killed. I am in Usmania University. Yeah, I will do a video call and show you. Don't worry. I did a video call and showed you. Nothing is happening. This media is also crazy, you all know. Right? Media is something which is, there should be regulations in internet. First person who will feel is Ram Gopal Verma only, right? But there should be regulations for internet in India, like China, we have in China, right? So there should be regulations in internet. Now, this is one thing which is interesting now. What is that? Internet jammers, internet blockage,
yeah.
Right? So if you think the government is stopping internet, now right to internet is a part of Article 21 of the Constitution, go file a case, who is stopping? Go file a case. People don't want to use that. People are using that. 60 petitions against CAA. But what judiciary said? It gave a date. January 22nd, it gave a date. And judiciary said, Supreme Court said, I'm not giving a stay order.